Okay, I want to talk about consonant sounds now, because we've talked about all kinds of different release valves and whatnot, but consonant sounds are really overlooked, and I've heard a lot of really strange ways of people presenting consonant sounds, and I'm just going to tell you my take on it, and everyone else can have their opinion, okay? Consonant sounds can also be our enemy. They're really not our friend. In fact, they do more to stricture back of the throat because the jaw has to do so much shifting. Remember I said I want you to keep that jaw open as much as possible? The jaw has to do so much shifting that you have to constantly negotiate going back and forth between different words. So it's really easy to sit here and, you know, you probably are going along the lessons and maybe you're a tenor and you're able to get all the way up to a high E or even higher, a soprano, and you're able to sing the octave C, C6, and you know, it's crazy, right? And then you try to actually apply this stuff to real time singing and you're going, man, I'm killing myself. I'm having all this trouble singing these phrases that I can easily sing my scales up there. Why can't I sing the phrases up there? This is maybe single-handedly one of the biggest reasons. We close the jaw down, which closes off the air in the back of the throat, the airflow in the back of the throat when we sing our phrases, right? All right, so what happens is as you stricture the air, you go back to your old habits, you start forcing air across the cord, you start squeezing the cord, choking on your own air, literally, and choking off the cord and inhibiting your ability, right? And a good example of this I like to use is there's an old Bad Company song. If I hear you knocking, yeah, upon my door, right? Right, so it's pretty belting willing. By the way, you know, for the R&B guy, if I hear you knocking, yeah, upon my door. It doesn't matter how you sing it. The point is that there's such a mouthful of lyric involved, okay? If I hear you knocking, yeah, upon my door, ain't no way I'm gonna answer it, right? Okay, so let's take this down a bit so I'm not screaming at you. If I hear you knocking, yeah, upon my door, ain't no way I'm gonna answer it. Cause cheating is the one thing and lying is another. And when I say it's over, that's it, I'm gonna quit. Right? And we can do it here. If I hear you knocking, yeah, upon my door, ain't no way. You know, as you're up there and you're singing, belting these things out, you're actually choking on your own consonant sounds, right? So here's what I want you to try. I want you to take your phrases and I want you to literally only sing your vowel sounds first. Sing those first and don't get caught up in the consonant sounds that's going to actually choke off the back of the throat. So, right? And then gently and slowly start to integrate in the consonant sounds. Now, I know this sounds crazy and weird, but it's amazing how well it works. I want you to picture yourself more like a ventriloquist who's trying to throw his voice and make you think that you're hearing words that you can't see me speak. In other words, if I hear you knocking, yeah, on my door, ain't no way I'm gonna answer it. Cause cheating is a one thing and lying is another. And when I say it's over, that's it, I'm gonna quit. Yeah. Right? All right, now notice, as I went through those phrases, I'm not going, if I hear you knocking, yeah. I'd kill myself. I'd never be able to sing any high range belting, wailing singing. Now you can, if you're not singing that heavy, if I hear you knocking, yeah, upon my door, and you're, ain't no way. If you're gonna sing it nice and gentle or whatever, yeah, you can get away with a lot more. But in the area of belting and wailing, or especially if you go up higher in your register, it's much more difficult to negotiate a mouthful of words that you're choking off the back of the cord as you go through the phrases, okay? So let's talk about a couple songs like a Starship song.
Sarah, storms are brewing in your eyes tonight. Sarah, no time is a good time for goodbyes.
Right? All right. Now, if you choke on all of those notes as you're going through all the phrases, you're going to find that you probably won't even last half of a song, if that. Okay? So my suggestion is work up your phrases first, only with the vowel sounds. Integrate the consonant sounds only as necessary. Keep your throat open, try not to shift the jaw at all if you can. And if you do ever so slightly, only to get out as much of the phrases as you need. And what you're going to find is if, for example,
say you will, say you won't, make up your mind tonight. Say you do, say you don't, be my guiding light.
Right? Instead of me going,
say you do, say you don't,
right? I'm barely, say you did, say you don't. I exchange out things. Like I don't sing hard T's.
Tomorrow, it's, oh tomorrow.
Instead of, oh tomorrow, I'm dead.
Oh tomorrow,
right?
Oh tomorrow.
And I'm singing my consonant sounds ever so gently, so I'm not slamming the consonant sounds and choking off the back of the chord, all right? Let's keep going.